Hello guys, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we are going to cover the calendar view, the Gantt chart view and the network diagram view. Let me take you to the next slide. As you can see, we have all this view. Now where I can find this view? You have to go to the task tab and under the task tab, you can see a Gantt chart icon. If you click on this drop down menu, you can see all this option out here. We will be specifically talking about the first three options, that is the calendar, Gantt chart and the network diagram view. Now let me give you a brief introduction that what does the calendar view says. The calendar view will give me the project information in the calendar layout. We will have a better understanding when we go on the practical approach. Moving on with the next one is the Gantt chart view. The Gantt chart view we have been using in all our project assignments and in all our videos. So this is the default view of MS project. Moving on with the next one is the network diagram view. Network diagram view will give me the detail of the project in a network diagram followed by an arrows. Let's try to understand more of it in our practical approach. In this video, we are going to talk about different type of views that I have in Microsoft Project 2013. In this video, we are going to specifically talk about the calendar view, the Gantt view, and the network diagram view. Alright, so let's begin. Now, in order to see the different type of view, I have to go under the taskbar, and under the task tab, I have to click on the Gantt chart drop-down box. If I click on this Gantt chart drop-down box, you can see there are various other views which are available with us. It says built-in, I have calendar, I have Gantt, and I have the network diagram. Let's start with the calendar view. So if I click on this calendar view, let's see what happens. I'm clicking on the calendar view. So now right in front of your screen, I can see there is a calendar view. On my left hand side of the screen, you see there is a calendar in which I can see the dates and the particular days of that particular month. Alright, and on the right hand side of my screen, I have all my tasks which are aligned according to their dates. So if you see on the top of this view, you can see there is a month, week and custom. Let's say what happens if I click on months. So if I click on months, it is giving me view month wise. This is for June 2017. If I click on this next arrow key, it is showing me the next month. And similarly, if I want to go to the previous month, I will click on this previous arrow key, right? I'll again click here. So I have all the views in month wise, distributed month wise. Let me see if I click on week what happens. So let me click on week. So out here I can see this has been again divided into weekly wise. So if you see, this is being segregated according to the week wise distribution of my task. Also, one thing I want to show you guys, that if I go on month view and if I go on this calendar, there you can see there are some orange bars. Now these orange bars are representing the task which is being involved in that particular week. If you see, these are some tasks, and even in the month of July, I can see there are some orange bar out here. So these are representing different tasks along that month. Now we have completed month, week. Now let's move to custom. Let's see what happens if I click on custom. So custom, the moment I click on custom, it is asking me weeks to display. So I can have my own customized view of the calendar. I can have it for number of weeks that it says 4. So on an average, it's for a month display. 4 weeks is a month, right? So I can click this as well. Or I can go for from. In this from radio checkbox, I can define the month and the time or the specific date from where I want it till where I need this. So it is asking from and to. So it is giving me an overall picture of that particular duration. If I click OK, so now it has been segregated according to my own requirement. So basically custom helps me to create the view according to my own requirement or according to my own dates. Alright, so this was about the calendar view in Microsoft Project 2013. Let's move on to the next one. If I click on this drop down box, I will go on Gantt chart view. Now this is the view that we have been seeing throughout all our videos, right? This is a very standard or default custom view for the particular project, and this is by default for Microsoft Project 2013. This is the view where I can see the task mode, task name, duration, start and finish, right? I have the table on my left hand side. On the right hand side, I can see there is a Gantt chart with some red bars which shows critical activity, blue horizontal bars which shows non-critical activity, and this is a default view with all the required details. All right, so this was about Gantt chart view. Now let's move on to the next one. If I click on this drop down box, and now if I click on network diagram, let's see what happens. So let me click on network diagram. So now out here I can see there is a chain of network which has been led by an arrow which is being shown in this view. Now in this view, if I go to any of the tasks, let me move on to my left hand side. Now it starts with project life cycle. I have identify, which is my next task. Then this is my major next task, that is planning. Now if I go on to this view and if I click on, let's say this, if I go on planning, it shows me the start duration, the finish time for it, the total duration in days, the task ID and percentage complete. Similarly, if I go to the project lifecycle, it is showing me the same details. It is showing me the start, finish, percentage which has been completed, the duration and the task ID. So this feature helps me to give me the overall project in a network diagram so that I can see what are the series of events which are being followed and what is the information, the details for this particular task. So if you see for identify, I have this minus button out here. So let's see what happens if I click here. If I click on this minus button, you have seen there's some change out here. So let's do it again. I'll click on the plus sign. It is collapsing and again getting it back by just click of this button. Now if you see for identify, requirement gathering and business analysis were the two subtasks for identify. Alright, so if I click on this minus drop down box, it will collapse. Let's see, yes, it is gone. Similarly, for planning, the subtask for them is master test plan, development strategies and completion of planning phase. So if I go on this minus drop down box, if I click on this, it will minimize all the required tasks, and if we click on the plus sign, I can see all the master test plan, development strategy and completion of plan phase. Alright guys, so this was all about the network view which helps me understand my project according to the network diagram.